to legends. This this posting is now full, and we will begin work on the next post, which is this one. And I will give you an update in vlog 173 on how that all gets on. Hopefully we'll be able to take off the formers and give you an insight into how the columns are looking. Morning legends, it's vlog 172, vlog 172 on the Miles Roldan channel. Welcome, welcome. I'm on my way to Sapian Capiz now for the dream home building project. If you saw vlog 171, you'll know that preparation has begun for the pouring of concrete in the columns of the third floor, so the top floor of that project. So come along for that ride and let's see what's happening when we get there. All right, on with the vlog. Legends, welcome, welcome to vlog 172 on the Miles Roldan channel. I've just arrived at the Dream Home Building Project in Sapian Capiz, Philippines. And what a sight it is, legends. Let's go in and have a look at the updates. So we've had 4 cubic meters of sand delivered. The first thing you'll notice from our supplier Gap. And from what I understand, the morning was spent by our labor team sacking up all the rice and transporting it to the upper floors, ready for borehole time. If you've seen vlog 171, you'll know that preparations were ongoing for the columns on the third floor, ready for the pour today. You'll also see we have a substantial amount of batu or sand, or sorry, stone. And another very important element of the mix, sand, stone and cement. And if you saw vlog 171, you'll know that we went and got quite a bit of cement from our lockup. Also, if you saw vlog 171, you'll know the whole vlog was focused on this carport and the what is the beginning of the carport floor. So we have cemented the first area, or the first part of the carport. This part that leads to the roadside will be later cemented with a slope. But this part is now cemented and concreted, sorry. And it will be ready for tiling as of when we decide to do so. And I think you'll agree, they've done a great job. Took the whole afternoon, but we got it done. Nice and even, solid. Oh yeah, we can to come play basketball, Noi. So yeah, they can park their bikes here, and this will be a nice little work area for when we begin the door frames. We have 9 door frames to make, because at this stage the door frames also need to be installed. So this will be a nice area to it looks like they've practiced already, do a bit of planing. So yeah, it looks like they've done a bit of practicing already here this morning. I wasn't here this morning, I had a few other errands to run in the city of Ra City, Capiz. But yeah, very happy with that. So Nonoi, Jovin and Boss Nanti are securing the water supply for our boreholes. So you've seen in previous scenes of this vlog, we have the sand, the stone, the cement and the water. Now the water is being secured. That's kind of all we need for concrete. Today's vlog will be dedicated on the third floor. Boreholes time. We are concreting one or two of the columns on the third floor. Our water pump is being readied with our hose. Apologies in advance, legends. This water pump seems to make a high-pitched noise, so you may hear that throughout the vlog now until we have a substantial amount of water. On with the vlog. Legend, so we are now on the second floor, the floor on up from the ground floor, and I want to give you a quick update on this floor, what's gone on. All right, let's go. So the first thing you'll notice, we're stocking our cement here. We have quite a bit of cement ready for what will happen and occur upstairs on the next floor up. As I mentioned, we will be pouring concrete into, I believe, 2 columns. I'll have to get up there and give you a more precise answer. So the cement bags are ready. Now today is January 24, which means it's been exactly 20 days or 3 weeks since the big pour, where we had a ready mix truck arrive and pour upstairs on the third deck. So we had our bamboo scaffolding supports on the underside of the deck on this floor, on the second floor, holding up the deck just in case the decks were to fail and fall through. It's now the 24th of January, exactly 20 days since that big pour, and Foreman Rocky has asked the guys to start removing the concrete scaffolding supports, sorry, the bamboo scaffolding supports holding up the decks. So now that they have been removed in this room, you'll see that these walls now can be filled up or filled in. These formats on the underside can now be removed and taken off. So progress. In this third room, we still we have removed the supports, but we still have a bit of the bamboos bamboo scaffolding that is on the outside. So yeah, all of the supports holding this steel deck up has been removed, but not all the bamboo. That will happen at a later day, I imagine. In the corridor, you'll see we still have those supports underneath, so we haven't got round to doing that. So that is amazing. So Foreman Rocky is demonstrating that he is on time. So as of the 24th, exactly 20 days since the big pour, he's already actioned that we remove the supports on the underside of this third floor steel deck. It's amazing. And legends, these are actually the supports. So we used these solid mahogany woods that we had spare from my last build in Rye City, the boarding house build. And we used them as the supports on the underside of this deck. So these have been removed from the other rooms. Let's, oh, my bedroom has also had the supports removed. There's one there that is just been left there, but the deck itself has no more support. So I would say a good 90% of this floor now is being held up now just by engineering, just by the steel deck and the concrete on top. So that's amazing. It goes to show that the 3 week window is right, and the guys are on top of the timeline, which is reassuring to me. I'm very pleased that the timeline has been adhered to, and they've done as they promised. See, Papa Half Day is back in the Gang Gang Legends. Good to have Half Day back. See, Nonoi Half Day. Papa Half Day. Axi Jobert. Gabiang Arte. Again, apologies for the high pitched noise that our water pump is sounding out. Alright legends, we're on the third floor, the top floor of the Dream Home Building project. I'm going to give you another insight into what's going on, but it's beginning to rain. So the timing is impeccable as always. So the guys now have brought everything up that we need. Water, sand, stone, cement. And now we have to give it a harlot, which is a mix. Ready for borehorse time, pouring time. And it's beginning to rain hard. Foreman Rocky is dealing with that column, but these columns here, 1, 2 and 3, look like they are ready to be poured. With our brand new plywood, which you would have seen us pick up in vlog 171 also. If you are an avid watcher of the channel, you'll know that. If you're not, catch up. There's over 170 vlogs for you to spend your time and binge watch. Get up to speed. All of these columns now are ready. You'll see we've spent quite a bit of time putting the steel rings, the stirrups, and the extending the rebar to the right heights. Oh, I'm very happy with the progress on the third floor. Tenoy and Foreman Rocky are charged with applying these formas, putting these formas onto these steel columns made of 16mm rebar and 10mm steel ring stirrups. The formas themselves are made of the frame is made of cocoa lumber from a coconut tree and plywood, which we picked up yesterday from the market just round the corner from here, around a 1.5 minute walk. And these forms hold the liquid concrete in and allow it to dry in the allows it to dry in the correct form. So Joba is just putting some liquid cement in just to lubricate the sides of the formas and just allow the liquid concrete to go in nice and easily and smoothly. Gives us a nice finish at the end as well. Right, legends, it's four horse time, it's just started. Pouring some concrete cement time. Right, legends, we have an old 10 pesos coin. No, sir, the postie. For the swerty, good luck. This is our front-facing column, one of the main structural load-bearing columns. So let's chuck a 10 pesos in for the luck. And legends, as this column is being poured, I just want to mention that Foreman Rocky and Tanoy are still continuing to establish these formas to set up these columns for, I would imagine, tomorrow morning. Today's focus will be these two. If we can squeeze in a third, we may do, but I think that will be asking for a lot. Remember, legends, to follow Miles Roldan on all social media, including TikTok, Instagram, and a big one here in the Philippines, Facebook. Just hit Miles Roldan, or type Miles Roldan in the search function of those platforms, and you'll see my friendly face. Give us a follow, give us a like, enjoy the content. And while you're at it, if you're new to my YouTube channel, hit that like button. And please, please, please subscribe. You'll be notified every time a new video is uploaded by myself. Thank you, legends. Thank you. You'll notice, legends, that the halot, the concrete mix now, is beginning to go lower than halfway. So Gerson now is beginning the next load by putting the sand in. So it's a continuous motion, legends. It's a construction game, it's not rocket science. You just got to work efficiently and get the job done. And I imagine by tomorrow, this will be allowed to dry overnight, and by tomorrow we'll be in a position to remove the forms and expose the column to the seat, to the heat and sunlight of the Philippine sun, and should be ready to load bear within a week or so. So there you go, the new halot, the new concrete mix is now being done. Stones will now be added. There you go, on cue. And water with sand and cement. If you have any questions regarding what you're seeing, legends, in blog 172, please put them in the comment section below. I will get back to you in that section or address your query in a later vlog. I hope you're well, I hope you're enjoying yourselves and watching this vlog in the comfort of your homes. So legends, this this posting is now full, and we will begin work on the next post, which is this one. And I will give you an update in vlog 173 on how that all gets on. Hopefully we'll be able to take off the formers and give you an insight into how the columns are looking. Alright legends, we're setting up for this second post for today. Exciting times here on the third floor of the Dream Home Building Project. So the water just cleans the inside, and then they'll pour the liquid cement in to give it a nice smooth finish on the sides. And then the whole process is repeated again until it's full, right to the top. And then it's left to dry, legends, for a day or two. And the formers will be removed, ready for load bearing. So this is the liquid cement. And again, it gives a nice smooth finish on the sides of each of the formers. Foreman Rocky is adding to the scaffolding, ready for the formers to be added on each side of this steel post. And work on the second post has begun. Exciting times. I've only got one pesos in me. Nisa bolsa, come on. For the suerte, give us luck. More money, more happiness, more love. Legends, that's it for vlog 172. Vlog 172 is in the can. I'm gonna go and edit it now. I hope to see you in vlog 173. With all that being said, it's me, myself and I, Miles Roldan. Thanks for watching.